Today we will focus our attention on renaming in IDA. Renaming in IDA is an important technique that can significantly improve the output and give us a better understanding of the program's behavior. After initial O2 analysis, IDA proposes dummy names that do not provide much information, and our task as reverse engineers should be to assign more meaningful names. The good news is that once you've changed the name, IDA will automatically propagate all name changes throughout the entire listing, and will also update the pseudocode. Let's start with something simple, renaming a stack variable. They are not associated with a certain virtual address, and, as you'll see, they do not appear in the names window. Place your cursor on a variable you want to rename and use the N hotkey, or right-click on the instruction and select Rename. Enter a name and confirm. Now you can see how IDA has changed all the occurrences of the old name in the context of the current function. If you rename a variable in disassembly while working in pseudocode, do not forget to refresh or press F5 when you switch views, just so the listing gets updated. If for some reason you would like to revert to the original name, just open the dialog again, delete the text, leave the field blank, and confirm. IDA will regenerate the default name. Another option is to rename a named location. The difference here is that the dialog provides the information about the exact address associated with the name and the list with options. Local name. If you would like to rename a local name within the scope of a given function, including names list. The dummy names are never added to the names list. Choosing this option will add the name to the names window, and later on you can easily find it and continue your work. Public name. If you would like to force a symbol to be treated as public. In most cases, this would have a minimal effect on the outcome and will add public annotations to the name. Auto-generated name. If the name is not auto-generated, it won't be deleted with the item. Weak name. Choosing this option will declare the name as a weak name, and if the current assembler supports the weak directive, IDA will use it. If not, IDA will just add the comment stating weak next to the name. Create name anyway. If the name you've just entered already exists, the normal approach would be to reject the change, but if you still want to go ahead and do that, IDA will try to variate the specified name by appending a suffix to it. The third type of name that could be changed is the register name. Within the scope of a function, IDA allows registers to be renamed. Whatever the reason you would like to change the name of a register, the process is the same as renaming in any other location. Except in this case, you can also double-click on the register. The dialog lets you specify new name to be used in the disassembly. Comment to be shown at the place of the new name's definition. Range of addresses where to use the name. The new name and the comment are printed at the start of the specified range. We hope that you enjoyed this video. Show us how we did it below, and don't forget to keep following our channel for more helpful content.